Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.3, Problem 6. This is Section 9.3, Problem number 6. It says, in a survey of 625 single people, 500 replied that if they were on a first date and their date spent too much time looking at their cell phone, they would not be interested in a second date with that person. Write a 90% confidence interval for the proportion of singles that would be put off by excessive cell phone use on a first date. So this is kind of an interesting confidence interval. So again, this is a confidence interval for population proportion, and the formula for that is p hat times the square root of p hat times 1 minus p hat over n times z sub c. So in order to fill that in, we'll really need to have a value for p hat, the estimate for the population proportion. So p hat equals r over n. So r, the number of successes, in this case, the 500 people who said that too much looking at a cell phone would be a deal breaker, over the 625 people that were surveyed. And you might not realize how nicely that comes out. So if you run it through your calculator, 500 divided by 625, it comes out to a fairly manageable decimal of 0.8, which is good. So now that I know p hat is 0.8, I can go ahead and fill in most of my formula. So the p hat is 0.8 plus or minus the square root of p hat, so 0.8, times 1 minus p hat, 1 minus 0.8, over n. N is the size of the sample. So again, for this particular problem, that's 625. And all of that's under the square root. The 625 is part of what's under the square root. And z sub c, the confidence coefficient. So this particular problem asks for a 90% level of confidence. And there is a chart that tells you the different confidence coefficients for the various levels of confidence that you could be asked to do. For 90%, the number for z sub c is 1.645. So that fills in the formula. Now we can go ahead and start doing the math. We have to start with the work under the square root. So 0.8 plus or minus the square root of 0.8 times 1 minus 0.8 will be 0.8 times 0.2. over 625, and then still times 1.645. So now I can multiply 0.8 times 0.2. I know that's 0.16. So I'll have 0.8 plus or minus the square root of 0.16 over 625. Times the z sub c value on the end, 1.645. Now I can divide 0.16 divided by 625, so that'll be my next step. So I'll have 0.8 plus or minus. So under the square root, when I do the division, 0.16 divided by 625, it comes out to 0.000256. So I'm going to have to do that square root. And I still have a 1.645 on the end. So now I can go ahead and do the square root. So it'll be 0.8 plus or minus the square root of 0.000256 is 0.016. So now I'm done with the square root finally. And I'm going to multiply that result of 0.016 times the 1.645 at the end. And when I do, I'm going to have 0.8 plus or minus 0.02632. So now I have one number after my plus and minus. So now I can split it off into a separate minus and a separate plus to get the low end and high end of my confidence interval. So the low end will come from 0.8 minus 0.02632. And the upper end of my confidence interval will be 0.8 plus the same number, 0.02632. So when I subtract 0.8 minus 0.02632, 0.32 will be 0.77368. That's the low end of my confidence interval. And the upper end, 0.8 plus 0.02632, will be 0.82632. So this is an interval that I'm 90% sure that the true population proportion lies in if I examined all the single people and asked them how they felt about cell phone use on a first date.